All right, boys and girls, so far this morning we've enjoyed listening to a story called Wake Up, It's Spring. Hopefully you finished your handwriting and finished the sentence about what you like to do in the springtime and did your very best coloring. This was the paper you should have done. Now, in your packet that you got on Friday, you received some of your old readers, readers that we've already learned to read, and maybe we've even marked the vowels on, and you also received a new reader. One of the things I'd like for you to do each day is try to read from your reader about 15 minutes. I know you can do it. Maybe you can read out loud some to mom, dad, brother, or sister. Read silently in your head. Remember, if we want to be a better reader, we need to practice, and that practice makes progress. So each day, I really want to encourage you to keep reading. Those readers are super helpful to help us be a better reader. If you need to mark the vowels, that's okay. Use your pencil and mark the vowels. Remember, there are also tricky words in our reader, but we don't ever mark our tricky words. But in your package, you also received a list of tricky words. The words on this side are tricky words that we've already learned, so you should know all these. Now, I did add a few new tricky words over here that we'll be learning and adding over to this side of our list, so I want you to also start practicing. If you forgot, remember, tricky words are words that we can't sound out. We just need to memorize them. We need to have them locked in our head. So I also want you to review those after you do some reading. Again, about 15 minutes in your reader. All right, practice reading out loud, practice reading quietly in your head. And then mom and dad, if you can also remember, ask questions about what they've read, see if they're remembering things that happened at the beginning of the story, the middle of the story, at the end of the story. Make sure as they're reading those booklets, especially the brand new booklet, that they're comprehending what they're reading. We want our readers to be able to read and decode the words, but we also want them to comprehend and understand the story. All right, in your packet, you also received several phonics sheets. This sheet is page 117. I want you to remember, we always put our first name. We leave a finger space and our last name whenever we see a house on our papers. Boys and girls, you remember this. Remember, we use our pencil to write our first name, finger space, and our last name. We're not going to do the front today. Today, I want you just to work on the back. All right? And mom, dad, brother, sister, whoever's helping you can also remind you that on this side, we have some pictures and some words, and these are all words that we've learned. These are short vowel words, and are a few magic E words. But we remember our vowel sounds. Remember short A, A, short E, E, short I, I, short O, A, short U, A. And use those sounds to sound out our words. Mom and dad, it'd be great if they would practice reading these. Again, these are all review words that we've done, but it's been a few weeks, so we might need a little review on some of our letters and sounds. After you've reviewed through these, make sure that you can read the words and then draw a line to match the picture. The pictures, mom and dad can tell you what they are. And boys and girls, you know how we take our pencil and we draw a line to match. Again, you can sound these out. I did spot a couple of magic E. Remember that magic E makes that vowel say its name. So don't forget to look for that magic E in the word. We're only doing the back of this page today. All right, it's kind of a good practice review since it's been a while since we've done some of that. First name, last name on the front. All right, when you're done with that, we also had a math page to do. It's page 105. When you look at it, again, this is a review of things that we've done. There's number words. These are number words that you can sound out, or it's number words that are tricky. And I know we've learned all these that you can read and then circle the correct number. We've got some addition problems. We've got some circle numbers that are more, numbers that are greater. Sometimes we say it like that. Those are different ways we say more, greater. On the back is a fun page of addition. Again, add them up. Mom and Dad, if they might have forgotten some of their skills with adding, we often use a manipulative of some sort. If you have some Cheerios, some pennies, something small, if they need to help them add. Many of them can already do the addition in their head and figure it out, but if needed, use something that they can count out is super helpful. When they're done, you can see there's a little connect the dots and even a little coloring on this math paper. On this, we can just X it out. We don't need to do that evaluation. If you want to, that's fine, but we're not going to do any kind of grade on this paper on video. You will probably notice they do mention at the bottom something about 2:30. We have not got to that skill yet. So if you do this page here with your child, don't worry if they don't know that. That is a skill that we'll be talking about soon. So just a quick little review math, things that we've done before we had spring break. So be sure and review and practice those. Also, boys and girls, if you haven't done it lately, remember to practice your counting. We've learned to count many different ways. Maybe you can show Mom and Dad how you can count to 100 all by yourself. Other ways we've learned to count, counting by fives. You can clap and count by fives to Mom, Dad, brother, or sister. And also we've learned to count by tens. So a good practice and review of counting by ones, fives, and tens. So those are just a few things to work on today, boys and girls. It's Monday. Hopefully you're also remembering to get out and get some fresh air, get some exercise. I know the other special teachers have reached out to you. Enjoy doing some of those activities too. I hope you all have a great day. Do your very best on your work. Boys and girls, I want you to remember to do your best work for your mommy and daddy. Be super helpful and patient with them. And I look forward to talking to you soon. Take care.